When to take MOTS-c peptide. So, by the way, MOTS-c is this beautiful mitochondrial encoded peptide. It activates these energy powerhouses in the cell. So if you think about it, on the timing perspective, it's unlike a growth hormone releasing peptide where you need to be in a fasted state, ideally before bed. It's different than like a tirzepatide or a GLP-1, but this peptide will give you a little bit of a boost. So ideally, you want to take it in the morning. And in this video, I'm going to show you why you want to take it in the morning. I'm going to show you what it does, and then I'll help you track your circadian rhythm so that you can get your biology completely aligned with the sun. So MOTS-c activates AMPK, adenosine monophosphate kinase. And this is a master regulator of cellular energy. So if you think of like a hybrid car where it can operate off fuel or off electrical energy, AMPK is a secondary bypass. And so if you have energy that seems to wane in the afternoon, or you may notice that you never feel fully awake in the day, you've got brain fog, or you don't have the endurance you want. One study that they did with MOTS-c to prove that it actually had energy generation capabilities is they took old mice and put them on a treadmill, and they compared how far the old mice could run compared to the young mice. The young mice could run roughly twice the distance as the old mice. They took the old mice off the treadmill, dusted them off, wiped off the sweat off their brow, and then every day they did injections of MOTS-c for a week or 5 days, and then they put them back on the treadmill. And guess what? The old mice could run just as far as the young mice could. So if you have an old mice that you're putting in a race, maybe like wants to break the 100 meter yard dash, make sure you give them MOTS-c. Or give it to yourself. How about that? So what MOTS-c does is it regulates your glucose uptake. And there's this transporter in your cells called GLUT4. And what GLUT4 does is it's activated when you exercise, so you can get glucose into the cell more rapidly without the presence of insulin. And GLUT4 transportation is this gold mine when it comes to regulating your blood sugar. Because if you always need insulin there, then it becomes kind of clumsy and it's a cumbersome system. And metabolic burnout happens when glucose is not being able to be utilized in the cell from insulin resistance. There's this great book by Benjamin Bickman called Why We Get Sick, and he goes deep into insulin resistance. So if you have skin tags, if you get hanger, if you notice that you just have to eat and you get like brain fog if you're hungry, you probably have some insulin resistance. Now, hunger is okay. It doesn't mean you have insulin resistance. That's just ghrelin. It's your stomach doing its job. It's called borborygmus. It's one of my favorite words to say. So say borborygmus 3 times. Okay, go. Repeat after me. Borborygmus. All right. So that's when your stomach is growling. But if you want better glucose regulation, MOTS-c can get you there. And MOTS-c is one of these what they call exercise mimetics. Now, I'm here to tell you that there's nothing that you can do to get the same benefits of exercise, because all this does is it's one pathway. MOTS-c is more expressed when you exercise and you get greater levels of AMPK. And so MOTS-c does mimic that part of exercise. Doesn't do the same thing the exercise does for your brain. You don't have that neuromuscular adaptation or the way your brains and muscles are communicating. So MOTS-c is just there to give you an enhancement, just a little boost. And the beautiful thing about this peptide is if you've got resistance of insulin, then it activates that GLUT4 transporter, so you get better utilization of glucose, better energy. And a lot of our clients, what they notice is that when they start using this, they just feel this little increase of solid energy. So I define health as being 3 things. Health is your great lifestyle. So you have a great lifestyle built around relationships, around experiences, around learning, and having a deep purpose. The second thing in health is it's about generating energy. So you want to be able to do the enjoyable activities that you love. So think of the activities that 10 years ago you were doing that you're not doing today because you just don't have the energy. Well, that would be a demerit on your good health. So you want to generate energy. And then the third thing is having fun experiences. So having this future that's so exciting that you can't wait to get out of bed in the morning and you're planning your life around this. I heard somebody say, show me your calendar, I'll show you your priorities. And that's where your priority is around having these meaningful, fun connections in life with the people that you love, learning new things, and then focusing on your health so that you're not missing some of those threats that can end life early. Everybody feels great the day before a heart attack, the day before a cancer diagnosis. So what we want is we want to make sure that you've got the right diagnostics, and those diagnostics can determine if MOTS-c may be right for you. The other thing that we found is MOTS-c, when you take it, if you do it at night, it might disrupt your sleep. Now, this is just anecdotally. I couldn't find anything in the literature that would confirm, but because you get that little energy boost, I have taken it at night, and I didn't sleep quite as deep. And knowing the mechanism of action, I said, well, I'm gonna take it in the day because that's usually when you're getting the MOTS-c expression. Ideally, you wanna sleep cooler. You wanna get like a chili pad or one of the 8 sleep mattresses that cools off your bed. And heat shock proteins are what activate MOTS-c. So if you think of your circadian rhythms, you're going to have more heat shock proteins, more activation. You're gonna sweat in the day and ideally not at night. Unless, you know, you're out of estrogen, ladies, and you know how those hot sweats feel, or dudes, if you're on too much testosterone, you get those night sweats, that's a good sign to go talk to your doctor and maybe get that dose a little lower, or maybe it's not the right treatment for you at the time. But if you take MOTS-c in the morning, and ideally either start with a small dose, see how your body tolerates it. This is one of those peptides that does have higher immunogenic properties, where that means if you have, you can develop a little bit of anaphylaxis response to it. You can get a little bit itchy. We see a small percentage of the population that has this effect. So have Benadryl with you, just in case. It's very rare, but it does happen. The other reason why you want to take MOTS-c in the morning is because it pairs well with fasting. So right when you wake up, it's a good time to give yourself an injection of the MOTS-c. It pairs well with fasting, pairs well with exercise, and especially if you're looking for more metabolic flexibility. And a lot of you in the program with us, you're doing one of our Ageless Future programs, and we train you on this eating window of constricting your eating window to 12 hours. We ideally want you out in the sun first thing in the morning. And if you're taking MOTS-c and methylene blue, so you see those little blue tablets we give you, and yes, they stain everything, so be careful. And be careful where you get your methylene blue. You want to get it from only the highest source of purity and all heavy metals removed. But what you'll find is if you combine MOTS-c, which helps activate the electron transport chain, so you get all these electrons that get pushed into the mitochondria, you'll get just a little better boost. And it's sunlight that activates it. Getting in the sun also resets the circadian rhythms, so your body knows when to wake up, and based on the cortisol and melatonin cycles. And then when you go to sleep at night, you'll just sleep really deep. And because it's regulating that glucose and that metabolism, you won't wake up as much to urinate. So follow the 3-2-1 method of sleeping 3 hours before you go to bed, stop eating 2 hours before you go to bed, stop drinking fluids an hour before you go to bed. It's a good time to just grab a book, just relax, meditate, reflect on your day, set goals for the next day, and you'll have a really great circadian rhythm. You know, once again, getting out in the sun activates MOTS-c, getting a sweat going every day, getting in the sauna, you know, 20 minutes roughly, an infrared sauna even better, using methylene blue. And then you can also use some NAD precursors. I like using 5-amino-1-MQ because it works on your body's own NAD salvage pathway. And then I like stacking it with SLOOP-332. This is another mitochondrial peptide that it resets some of the circadian rhythms as well. So if MOTS-c, if this is fascinating to you and you want to say, hey, is this right for me? And now I know when the best time is to take it. Now I need to know where to get it from a reputable company. We only use compounding pharmacies that are 503A, 503B licensed facilities. You can go to agelessfuture.com, set up your free health span assessment, and then our team will get your blood labs ran, get you with one of our talented medical team, and we'll help you put the right protocol together. And by the way, I've got a free gift for you. So if you click on the link below, you can get a free download of my book, The Peptide Blueprint. Hope you love the video. If you do, please share it, subscribe, leave us a great review, and I'll see you on the next video.